Clashes broke out between Palestinians and Israeli police in East Jerusalem on Sunday. Protesters threw stones and set towers on fire as police officers on horseback used stun grenades and fired tear gas to repel them. They're just the latest incidences of violence in the city, which has seen tensions escalate during the Muslim holy month of Ramadan. One of the issues fueling the anger is the planned eviction of Palestinian families from the Sheikh Jarrah neighborhood by Jewish settlers. The case was put on hold on Sunday for several weeks after Israel's Attorney General secured a deferment of the High Court hearing scheduled for Monday. A lower court had ruled in favor of the Jewish settlers' claim to the land. Palestinian Nabil Kurd welcomed the delay to the case.
I'm very optimistic because of the court's decision, because the legal system is not able to reach a decision in this case. And the reason is because deep inside, they know that this land is Arab-Palestinian and the papers have been forged.
But one Israeli who identified himself as Yaakov said it should go ahead.
I think it's a disgrace that after 2 weeks of brutal violence against Jews in the neighborhood unprovoked, that the courts decided to reward their violence, to reward their terrorism, and to delay the ruling.
Tensions are expected to remain high over the coming days, despite growing international calls for calm. On Monday, Israel will mark Jerusalem Day, its annual celebration of the capture of East Jerusalem during the 1967 Middle East War. The status of the city is highly contested. Palestinians want East Jerusalem as the capital of a future state in the occupied West Bank and Gaza. Israel views all of the city as its capital, including the eastern part that it annexed in a move that has not won international recognition.